Faced with a low vaccination rate, the Ministry of Health organized a national consultation on St. Lucia's COVID-19 vaccine policy to get a better understanding of the public views on COVID-19 vaccines. The activity was an open forum and saw stakeholders from a wide cross-section of society participating in the activity, including the legal fraternity, trade unions, the religious sector, commercial sector, tourism sector, community leaders, and the media. Among the panelists included Chief Medical Officer Dr. Sharon Belmar-George, pathologist Dr. Stephen King, and immunization manager Tecla Jean-Baptiste, who made presentations on the public health situation and also the historical precedents of vaccines. Dean of Law at the University of the West Indies, Professor Rosemary Bell Antoine, and Sir Dennis Barron, a former CARICOM Court of Justice president, provided a legal perspective on the COVID-19 vaccine debate. By all accounts, the discussion was a very informative one, says the CMO, giving public health officials an idea of where the country stood in reaching its herd immunity target.
It ranged from those members who were completely against the use of the vaccines, and they were able to give us what some of their fears were, what some of their concerns were, and they also indicated how they would prefer vaccines to be rolled out, how they wanted it to be made available to the public and to who. And we also got some members, for example, from the business sector who indicated their responsibility for providing a safe environment for their staff to work. So we did take note of the viewpoints of a lot of those stakeholders, and we invited them in 1 week to provide their position paper, which we are going to use to guide so that Cabinet can get a feel of the opinions and the ideas and the views of the various stakeholders for their information.
One of the key takeaways from the discussion for pathologist Dr. Stephen King was that the fight should not be against each other, but rather using the limited weapons available to fight the COVID virus.
For me, it is for all of us St. Lucians to appreciate that and then make our choices, make our decisions to move ourselves into that safer place. Follow protocols and get vaccinated. This is really all we can do. That's all we have available to prevent ourselves from suffering. So that's what I would like to see. And I would like to see it in throughout the community, the entire community. What I would love to see is an all-out national strategy with all stakeholders on board, all communities on board, house to house. I would like to see a massive national campaign which engages every St. Lucian, because this is a war against the virus. And the soldiers in this war is each and every St. Lucian. And so for them to fight this battle, they need to be fully informed and they need to have full access to all the tools that they require to fight the enemy, the virus.
Both Dr. King and the Chief Medical Officer agree that there is need for more public engagement about the vaccines.
The more we educate, the more we engage. In fact, the more we become educated, because I don't have all the information and knowledge. I learned in that consultation, speaking to people, right? For instance, I'll give you a classic example. We talk about people being anti-vaxxers. But if you look at all the, as somebody made the point, if you look at all the unvaccinated people, they're not all anti-vaxxers. Many of the unvaccinated are people that just have concerns. And all they need is some information, somebody to take the time to listen to their concerns and assure them or give them the evidence that they can be so assured that the vaccine is safer than COVID.
Last week's consultation is the first of others to come. Another consultation has been planned, this time with local pediatricians and officials of the Ministry of Education, to discuss COVID-19 vaccine for children with the introduction of the Pfizer vaccine. For the DBS News World, I am Zaid Romulus.